unity. In the preceding paragraphs, that means the coming paragraphs, we will be learning about how diverse culture exists in various parts of a country. So in these coming paragraphs, we are going to learn how so much of difference is there in our country, diversity of culture is there in our country. But you would be amazed that India is famous in world for the unity in diversity. But it's so amazing to know that though we have so much of diversity, we are all united. That's the beauty of India. Though we are having different variety of culture, but we all are united. Rama and Krishna are two gods whose epics of Ramayana and Mahabharata have deep roots in the whole of India. So you must have read about, many of you must have heard about, must have watched in the TV. A lot of shows come about Ramayana and Mahabharata. During the lockdown period, it was repeated, telecast was done of Ramayana and Mahabharata. So you must have seen in that. The forms of prayers and languages and rituals may vary, but the theme is common. So in both, you will see the forms of prayer and rituals and culture may be a little different, but theme or the main aim of these both epic is same. According to Ramayana, Lord Rama was born in Ayodhya, which is on the banks of Ganga in Uttar Pradesh. He traveled through the whole of India and fought a war with Ravana across the coast of Rameshwaram, that is in Tamil Nadu in Sri Lanka. Similarly, the epic of Mahabharata brings out the epics. So what the first one says, if you will read Ramayana, though Rama was born in Ayodhya in UP, he traveled across the country and fought a war with Ravana, which is in Tamil Nadu, that is in Sri Lanka. Okay. Similarly, if you will read the epic of Mahabharata, we will read the stories of Lord Krishna. He was born in Mathura, but he went to Gujarat. But Lord Krishna's devotees you will find across the country. So you won't see that Sri Krishna is worshipped only in Mathura and Gujarat. You will see that he is worshipped in many parts of the country India. Lord Krishna's devotees are spread across the country. The world famous Tanjore paintings of the south are mostly centered around the theme of Lord Krishna. If you will go to south, the paintings of Tanjore, you will see there Lord Krishna's paintings are done. So that shows the culture, diversity and unity of India. Though they are born in one place, but they are worshipped across the country. Okay. Next is Shiva, a famous god of Hindu, has followers from Kashmir to Kanyakumari. People believe that Lord Shiva's abode is in Himalaya, and the famous shrine of Amarnath attracts pilgrims from across India. So we'll see that Shiva is worshipped not only in the north but whole of India in the south also. Though we believe that Lord Krishna's home or place to reside was in Himalayas, which is in the north. And his famous shrine is a holy place to worship. Amarnath attracts lot of pilgrims from all over the India. People come to Amarnath, the holy pilgrimage of Lord Shiva, to worship him, to pay homage to him. Now, Buddhist temples in Gaya are common places of pilgrims for all Hindus and is not limited to Buddhist. And if we go to Gaya, you will see the Buddhist temple is full of lots of Hindu. It doesn't mean that it is a Buddhist temple in Gaya, where not only Buddhist, Hindus also go. Okay. So, place of pilgrimage for all Hindus and is not only limited to the Buddhist. That's the beauty of India. The Jain temples of Dilwara in Rajasthan also attracts a lot of pilgrims from people of other faiths. So Jain temple in Dilwara, which is in Rajasthan, many other religious people also go to visit the Dilwara temple. The Sufi saints of India have contributed a lot towards uniting the bonds between different culture and regions of India. So a lot of Sufi saints are there. You have Bhakti saints and Sufi saints. So Sufi saints have contributed, given a lot towards uniting a great binding between different culture of different regions of India. And Muslim places of pilgrims like Dargah of Hazrat Khwaja Moinuddin Chisti at Ajmer, Dargah of Hazrat Nizamuddin Aulia in Delhi, and that of Haji Ali in Mumbai are places of pilgrimage for people all in faiths. So in these Muslims, what we say the pilgrimage, not only the Muslims go, all other religious people also go to pray in these different, what we say, the dargahs. Gurudwaras are also visited by the people of different religion. Famous Gurudwara, that is Guru Ka Langar, also common kitchen system, serves food to everyone in respective of their religion. So Gurudwara is not only visited by the Sikh people, every religion people go and visit the Gurudwaras and they sit there for the langar. All faith people can sit and eat there. Then festival are shared by followers of all religion. People take part in each other's festival. National festivals like Republic Day and Independence Day are celebrated by every citizen of India. These are perfect example of unity in diversity. So we celebrate different festivals together. Christmas is celebrated by everyone. Diwali is celebrated by everyone. And we wish each other on Eid. So that shows, though we are different, we are united. Even we all, Hindu, Muslim, Sikh, Isai, celebrate together the national festivals. The national unity is clearly visible during sports events, where the spectacular cheer the Indian team without any bias of caste, religion, of play, of the player. So national unity also we can see when the sports are being played. All those who sit and watch, they cheer the Indian team without being thinking of, oh, he is Hindu or Muslim. It is only we praise and cheer up them because they are Indian. We all stand together under the same national flag and sing the national anthem, and there is no separate anthem for a separate region of the country. So though we have different regions in India, but we have one national anthem. So all the above aspects show how people of our country unite together and live in harmony despite the difference in their culture. So our country is thus famous in the world for its cohesive spirit and unity. So children, though we all are different in our religion, in our culture, in our thinking, but we need to be united always. That we have to do, because that is the beauty of India. Though we all are different, follow different culture, religion, tradition, but we need to respect each other. We need to love each other. Then only we can grow up ahead. Okay? Thank you.